Welcome to Markets.com. You're watching a company profile of Electronic Arts, one of the leading interactive entertainment software companies. Founded in 1982, EA is based in Redwood City, California, with John Riccitiello as the CEO. Over 9,000 employees worldwide work for EA, developing software for video game systems, personal computers, cell phone handsets, and the internet. Electronic Arts is listed on the New York Stock Exchange, where it is traded on the NASDAQ under the ticker symbol ERTS. The fact that Electronic Arts was once the top video game publisher made it a company that was able to sustain organic growth while it made successful acquisitions. Today, the company still looks at both options for future growth possibilities. Organically, the company still has successful franchises that continue to make sales year in and year out, and this is best seen in their EA Sports franchise with their sales of Madden and FIFA. Sales of some of their products, however, have been slowing down while arch rival Activision has been hitting on all cylinders. As their organic growth has been slowing, EA has been looking for acquisitions to juice their growth, while their acquisitions have been heavily skewed towards the online space, with their acquisition of Mythic being the best example. The company developed their very popular MMORPG Warhammer that competes with Activision Blizzard's World of Warcraft. The company also looks at casual gamers to fuel their future growth. These gamers have become all the buzz in the sector with the recent success of the Wii, which is the top-selling next-generation system and has been scooped up by casual gamers for its simple, relaxed gameplay. While EA has been in this sector for a while, they are ramping up their production on the Wii platform to meet the unexpected demand for the system. The company is also trying to reach the casual gamer through online games and games for cell phones. In the online game sector, they have Pogo.com, one of the top 10 sites monthly visited in hours. In the mobile game sector, their most successful game has been Monopoly Here and Now. That has been on the bestseller list for the last few months. As for the company's outlook, in early December, EA announced that it would not meet its profit or revenue forecast for the fiscal year. A lot of analysts jumped up and said that gaming was not as recession-proof as previously thought. Then a couple of days later, NPD reported video games numbers for November, in which there had been an 11% increase. It seems obvious that while video games are holding up, EA is not, and the reason is simple. The management doesn't seem to be doing as well as other companies. They have not been able to keep costs down at their development studios, and margins have gone down. Their games are also having trouble selling like they did in the past. A few years ago, the Madden franchise was growing, and now it is stagnant, and their NBA Live struggles to compete with NBA 2K9. Some of its recent games, like Mirror's Edge, Spore, and Dead Space, have done well, but nowhere near where the company or analysts had expected. While the company was hoping to start franchises with all of them, Spore did poorly in comparison to the hype it got ahead of its release. The company restructured last year into four segments in an attempt to improve the company operations, although so far it doesn't look like much progress has taken place. The company's problems are not recent, as they do date back to the months before the launch of the Xbox 360, while the problems they were having at that time are still in existence now. Even though the stock has suffered huge losses in the last few months, the economy is getting worse, and that's exacerbating the company's individual problems. Thanks for tuning in to Markets.com. See you soon.